I found a lead that may help us unravel more about Zero Day and the bombings we ate shit for. I've picked up an encrypted signal from the Tone conference site that's been broadcasting on a loop since the night of the bombing. Go investigate. You might even get to try out that fancy new AR tech we stole. I mean, creatively shared.
All the bodies and that. Oh, fuck.
So what's with the security? This building should be under construction, not under guard.
Oh, shit, I didn't think of that. Anyway, what am I looking for, Bags?
Any kind of device or component that could still be emitting the signal. It seems to be coming from within the rubble.
What the fuck?
This is it. The signal is coming from this spider bot fragment. No indication yet who it belongs to.
Oh, fuck. It looks like my mum after quiz night. What happened to it, though?
Difficult to say, but with an AR reconstruction, we may be able to see what happened to it and if it relates to the attack. Access data relays in the vicinity, and I can compile enough data to build the AR reconstruction. Perfect. Two more data relays to go. Data relay and I'll have it.
Men down!
To do it. Now I'll just take the audio from this stream and the video from these 36 and got it. Go back to where you found that spider bot and I'll show you the AR reconstruction from the night of the explosion.
Yeah, got it.
CTOS AR. Data reconstruction in progress.
You brought the payload?
What, think we'd go back here?
Don't trust the Kelly dog.
my days, you telling me Clan Killy gangsters done the bombing?
Looks more like a handoff, like the Killies weren't providing supplies.
Cuz, look, they clearly ain't with Clan Killy. Does that mean they're with Zero Day?
Well, don't just stand there, keep looking.
Hey, Bags, who was controlling that Spider-Bot? Do a scan or something.
I've now fully decrypted the signal the Spider-Bot is broadcasting. And while I cannot identify a specific user, it is a call code used by the Metropolitan Police Service.
Hold on, the police watched this happen?
The reconstruction continues behind that rubble.
Yo, what if we could just, like, quantum leap through this shit, huh? That'd be wicked.
Quantum tunnel technology is at least 10 years away, but spider bots and drones are here today. You could try one of those if you don't feel like waiting.
Ah, bless, bruv.
Why don't you aim those human eyeballs of yours at the van's cargo?
Yeah, got it.
RDX nitrogen, and the exact same detonator system like the bombs that were planted at Parliament.
Ah, that's Zero Day's signature.
Yeah, hurry. We've got order delivery.
So you were hired to supply all the targets?
Shut it. We're all on need to know.
Yo, Zero Day had multiple crews running this shit. Kelly's were just a cog.
That's certainly one way to pull off a massive coordinated attack while remaining anonymous. Zero Day needed manpower and resources, but they needed them at an arm's length. And it doesn't take the world's greatest AI detective to see that both Clan Killy and Albion benefited in the aftermath. Unfortunately, this is the most we can get out of the AR reconstruction. But if we could find the mystery officer who was spying through the Spider-Bot, maybe they could tell us more. Tracing the Spider-Bot's serial number, it was assigned to New Scotland Yard 3 years ago. Perhaps more information about its user or its assignment will be available at the station.
Ah, it's fucking bullshit, man. The feds knew it wasn't DedSec that did the bombings, but they kept letting everyone believe it.
The only way to know for sure is to investigate New Scotland Yard.
Thank you.
You see this? Albion's taking over Scotland Yard.
And the entire police service. But don't worry, if you're not pleased with your privatized goon squad, just take your business across the street.
I mean, fuck the feds, but fuck Albion too, man. Fuck all of this.
Not to worry. The only difference now is the uniform, assault weapons, and the fact they're motivated by profit over public service. Now, any record or information on the Spider-Bot will be further in.
It's only
around.
A matter of time.
Is this the right Spider-Bot?
According to the serial numbers, this matches the piece of Spider-Bot from the Tone bombing site.
Can you peep? You last used it.
Navigate the Spider-Bot from out of that room. I'll need a direct connection in order to learn more from our bisected friend.
Cool, I'm all over it.
Search. I have this one.
That opening right there looks like a good exit point. That's a part of the remote detonator system from Parliament. If the Met, or Albion rather, actually analyzed it, they would see it wasn't DedSec's handiwork at all. Right, get comfy. This spiderbot might be broken and missing some of its legs, but it can still jump and fit through vents. That's a good way to get through the station undetected. That's Dalton's mask. It must have been recovered from Parliament. It might be the only thing left of him now. Buggery fuck, would you look at all this junk? You'll have to jump your way across to get to the next vent opening. Almost there. Make your way through this last bent path.
Yep, got it.
Scanning Spybot and accessing its internal drives. While I'm analysing this data, you should make yourself scarce. Unless you'd like to explain to your new, heavily armed, privatised police force why you've broken into the station.
Sure, whatever.
The Spiderbot fragment you found has a satellite-based GPS module that regularly pushed its location to a specific ground station.
Come on, Bags, don't leave me hanging. Where do we go?
Pushing you the ground station's coordinates. The GPS history of the Spiderbot we recovered regularly pinged these coordinates. Our mystery witness to the real bombers must have come to this lovely, damp location several times.
That's a good spot to do some shady shit.
Or to discreetly dump a body into the Thames.
I'll find us a way in, Bags.
I'm detecting a surveillance network guarding a space under this bridge. If you can patch into it, perhaps you can take a look inside.
Hey, check this shit out. It's the fucking Batcave down here, but for, like, cops or whatever.
Well, if Albion was stomping all over your workplace, you'd find a different place to store your lunch too. And it seems our mystery officer was dedicated.
So how'd they end up sniffing around the tone bombing?
The computer's dusty enough to kill an asthmatic, but there may still be something useful on it.
This is Inspector Caitlin Lau. Well, former inspector now, since Albion's coup. The Met is no more. The police brass had already buried the evidence anyway. Everything implicating Albion and Clan Kelly in the bombings. But I know Mary Kelly's band of twats were involved, and they're involved in other crimes we can look into. Me and a few good mates are willing to go off book, going after Mary Kelly again. I'll never fucking learn, will I?
Inspector Caitlin Lau, video log. Clan Kelly and Albion are teamed up on some deal. I don't have all the details, but it looks to be human trafficking. The European Processing Center is the Albion angle. Since the bombings, they can grab anyone off the street. Call them illegal immigrants, potential dead-sick insurgents, whatever. Though we know who the real danger is. So, Clan Kelly gets hold of these people, these immigrants, deportees, victims, really, and they're taking them somewhere. But where and why? It all comes back to the boss lady herself. I knew she was into something, but she wriggled off the hook. There's only one way I can do this. 24/7 surveillance on Mary Kelly. If I'm caught, well, this will be my last entry. But I have to see what she's hiding.
So, our mystery officer was Inspector Caitlin Lau. It sounds like Mary Kelly was her white whale, and her investigation led her to the bombings.
Wait, so Albion's in with Clan Kelly? Man, fuck the feds. I've been saying that forever.
It seems like Zero Day's web covers all of the unsavory bits of London. Tug on a thread, and it leads back to them. Clan Kelly and Albion included.
Snatching people off the streets? Bro, that's so fucked up. You know what? Let's do something about it.
Inspector Lau mentioned Albion is running their part of the operation out of the EPC. Detectives like us call that a lead.